Oh, excuse me, surfer dude. Do you know where this shit pipe is? He goes, yeah, we're standing on it. I'm a professor over at Loyola Marymount University, and that's with Marine Sciences. I'm teaching undergrads, and I did complete my PhD in marine biology, and that's an ongoing project with NOAA. I'm working with coastal sharks, where there's two different species of sharks that don't get any eye diseases, and I'm trying to find ways to cure human eye diseases because of that.
None of this crap was here. There used to be a dirt, big giant dirt field here, and they used to have to park across the street. And then when, later on, they started parking over here. We started parking over there before the bridge was put in. But yeah, the old days, the prehistoric days, when the cars used to line up right here, the local boys are just straight up.
One peak, you know, it's not, you know, a beach of peaks, it's just one peak, and we're always on it all the time, so, I mean, it's basically it, man. So, to all you people home watching this, don't paddle out here.
Foam ball is just when the tube fills up with the foam, and you get back on the foam ball, and then the wave kind of slows, and the foam just pushes the body surfer, or the body boarder in this case, out. So, I mean, the deeper you are, the more on the foam ball you are, you know? So, on the foam ball, baby. to snake people.
Huh?
Sorry, Mark, I had to snake you on that one.
Well, what a figure, they got it. What is good if they got it.
But it beats a stick in the eye, right?
Surf there a lot. It was just a real cool little peak that you could get a quick turn off of, and it didn't go very far, but I mean it was fun and kind of scary looking at the pipe. I was always just afraid I was just going to get, and I didn't like it just because I fell a lot.
Getting gnarled by the rock.
Yeah, and it was sharp and it was nasty looking. Yeah, I've never heard it called anything but.
That's the reaction you first get when you tell people, oh yeah, I'm gonna go surf Shitpipe. It's like,
we just need one.
Well, what, you would make a choice to do that?
Shitpipe is a misnomer. Maybe in the 1980s it was correct and valid, but nowadays, for the past 20, 25 years, it's predominantly some of the best water quality coming from our wastewater treatment plant. So I think it's just the kids like saying it.
Well, I learned something new. The beach is called the shit pipe. And you know, it's cool.
I think the construction was in the 30s. And when you come over to the house, I have a photo of it being built that you can take a picture of with raw sewage all over the beach, like a lagoon. The Black Lagoon, beautiful little thing. Too bad it's not still here. Be a lot less people.
Well, I don't know. Some of the older guys were telling me that they used to let the shit just right out onto the sand. You know? And I guess they may put the pipe here back in the 60s or 70s, and it was active for a while, but they don't really use it. It's more of like a, like emergency pipe, I guess, if the other ones get backed up, so.
It's like encased. It's always been kind of like that from the times of what I remember.
Yeah, I don't remember them changing that pipe.
Yeah, because I just remember it always was encased. It always was just this flat, crusty looking thing. Like when low tide was out there, you could always just see, I mean, bigger than this, but it's just like a flat platform with a ton of barnacles.
But it used to be a big old pipe, like all the way up there. And before it was a beach, they used to pull all the junk into the water.
Yeah.
And then what they did was, it's still underneath the sand, but then they turned it into a beach.
Back then, we didn't really pay attention to water quality. I don't remember anybody ever thinking that it was unhealthy to surf there. Not because, just because we never thought about that at all, you know. I mean, we surfed in Bologna Creek.
I didn't say.
Right in the creek, which is, you know, now we know is like the biggest discharge of pollutants in the watershed.
That's not bad. It's worse down in Malibu, I think. You know, like Palisades, where all the runoffs are. I mean, over here, people just say that. I don't even know why they say that. It's not even that bad. It probably gets better water quality than Malibu or El Porto and stuff like that, you know?
I'm very cautious to say how resilient the aquatic life is, because then people might think that, well, we could keep dumping and everything's just going to take care of itself. But there's going to be a point that it's overwhelmed. There's whole species of different marine life that are now extinct. Not that they're going extinct, they are gone, especially a species of blue shark. And a lot of that, more or less, is because of human consumption, not so much of the pollutants in the water, but still, we need the whole food chain to be there in order for it to work.
You know, there's multiple ways of dealing with urban runoff. One of them being diverting it to the sewage treatment facility. And, you know, to us, that seems like a waste. You know, the other alternative for treating urban runoff is trying to reconstruct natural systems, you know, coastal wetlands that used to naturally treat that runoff. The vegetation would take up the bacteria and nutrient loads naturally. Not to mention providing habitat for, you know, a long list of species that are endangered now because we've already filled and destroyed all our coastal wetlands. So you kind of get, in our perspective anyway, you get more bang for the buck doing this with a natural process and not pouring so much money into these mechanical treatment facilities. But again, you know, Los Angeles hasn't decided how they're going to deal with these multiple water quality problems. And that's one of the things that we want to focus on in this paddle out is, you know, we want to know what those plans are.
God, I hope somebody shows up to this thing.
Be a real drag.
Be real terrible. It's just mess.
I want to thank you guys all for coming out today. This is a local event that's taking place with Surfrider chapters around the nation today. Paddle Out for Clean Water. And this guy's heart is in the same place as ours, and it means to do something about it. Bill has a great open barrel policy, and we encourage all of you to visit him and staff in the field offices. Bill Rosendahl, everybody.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. You really don't want to listen to a politician or whatever I might be at this point in my life. You want to get out into that water there, and I see your surfboards. But I wanted to come by and acknowledge what you are doing. Today, across the country, as you well know, thousands of people are at the beaches, and the whole purpose of it is to protect the beaches. This is Mother Nature at its best, and this is what we are blessed to have right here in Los Angeles.
Kind of ironic that we're paddling out for clean water at Shitpipe, but let's go get wet.
Tell you a story. I'm gonna tell you about my town. I'm gonna tell you a big fat story, baby. It's all about my town. Yeah, down by the river.
It was awesome.
Excellent.
Big, big spin. Spin for clean water.
Right on.
Right on, Jazz? Was that good? Yeah.
Good. Mission accomplished?
It survived.
Tough paddle. Mission accomplished?
Mission accomplished. I got him out. I had to tow one of them. Way too much fun. Cool. Take care.
Yeah. You see good people out there surfing?
I want to go surfing. Man. I guess that'll work, huh? I've never ridden one of these things before, though. Is there a front and back? I don't know.
Yeah, you got it. You're in the front now. You
like there's some reef sharks. You can see at the bottom, but I didn't stay down long enough. But an artificial reef has grown all around it. It creates a nice surf there too, it looks like. That guy was doing all kinds of 360s. Right there at the bottom, there's crustaceans. Saw lobster, saw the tentacles of a lobster. Many different types of shrimp and worms. It's just a variety of marine life there. So for an underwater dweller like me, it's a great little secret.
Surfing out here by himself one day, and it was overhead, and he hit the pipe and had to drive himself to the hospital. He got like 20 stitches in his scalp, but that's about it, I guess. My soul is like a ruin, and I feel like
you can find the shit, come and show it to me.
Drove down to the sea.